Welcome to UFC 226 Fight Week. I'm Megan O'Leary, joined by the baddest man on the planet, the UFC heavyweight champion of the world, Stipe Miocic. Stipe, thank you so much for joining me today.
Thanks for having me.
Let's get down to the most important thing. You've got a baby on the way. Just could be days.
Yeah, it could be right now as we speak.
Oh my gosh, I hope it's not.
I hope not either. I think we're good.
Tell me about how it was balancing these responsibilities, because the fact that your wife is so close to delivering, I mean, that means you had a lot of weight to carry on your shoulders.
No, I made her do all the work, you know. I made her put the stuff together.
Heavy lifting.
I took a lot of naps, so I didn't know what she did. But we had a lot of time in between, so before the fight, and I got a lot of stuff done before camp really started, so it was good. Plus, I had a lot of friends helping me out, and my brother-in-law and all that, so it worked out well.
Did you ever feel like mentally there was a lot of stress on you, or are you good at compartmentalizing?
I'm good at shifting it different ways, and with work and that, and it was all good. And my wife's amazing, and she helped out a lot too, so I'm very lucky to have her.
She certainly is. I feel like I remember when you guys first started dating, we were talking about Michael Kors watches.
Yeah, the watches, the rose gold. I remember that day. That was fun. Yeah.
Yes, till now.
First time we ever met. That's the first time I think we ever met.
Yes. So am I the godmother? Is that like what's happening?
I'll throw a full call in.
Okay, because I'm Italian. It means a lot.
I understand
in
that.
In my culture. Yeah. So.
My wife's Italian too, so I'll talk.
So when I show up at your house with like some earrings and a gold cross necklace for your daughter,
I'll wear a wife beater with like a big gold chain.
Yes, so. Perfect.
We'll make it right.
Stir the sauce. Yeah. It'll be great.
Hey, okay. Guy.
All right, so let's move on to me being a professional here with my job. You're fighting Daniel Cormier. You guys in Boston were getting along so great. It seemed like you wanted to spend time around one another. Has that vibe now shifted because you have to face each other on Saturday?
Listen, it's business. We're trying to beat me up. I'm going to beat him up. It's part of the game. I haven't seen him at all since the time I've been here. So,
He's
doing well, but he'll see me Saturday, so I'm not going anywhere.
Talk to me about, after your fight in Boston. I actually had spoken to Dana before I spoke to you, and I said, Daniel Cormier mentioned maybe he'd like to fight you. Is that something you were interested in? And you said, yeah, we'll see. We'll talk. I want to go home first. Was that a surprising call out for you, or surprising to the fact that he did want to come up and face you?
I'll fight anyone. I don't really care. But they came with it. We talked, and it all worked out.
It certainly did, and we're here now. It's days before the fight with Daniel, and this is certainly a fight that you've well prepared for. You're very confident in your abilities, but let's talk about the actual matchup. He is much smaller than you in both height and reach. Have you faced an opponent of that size before?
Yeah, Roy Nelson. I fought Roy Nelson, so maybe a little bit taller than DC, but not much. But I think I brought some good guys in to help me out. I'll be ready.
Obviously got the wrestling background. You're no slouch in the wrestling department either. You're known for your hands. He's no slouch in the stand-up. When you break this down stylistically, what do you see?
I'm a better fighter all around. I know he says he's a better fighter, but come Saturday, you'll find out. Big mistake when you find out in the middle of the octagon.
What about this 25 minutes? Do you believe that helps you?
Yeah, I think it doesn't matter if it goes 30 seconds or 25 minutes. I don't really care. I'm going to win.
This is a huge week for the UFC, right? Like, International Fight Week is always the biggest event of the year, and it's got all these fun festivities for fans surrounding it all. Does it matter to you?
No, I do my thing. I'm going to go do my thing, do my appearances I have to, my obligations for the week, and then get ready for Saturday.
Is there anything that riles you up? Is there anything that, you're like, yes, I can't wait to do this during fight week? Because it's just fight.
I actually play cards with my coaches, hang out, late night, and play some euchre and call of the day.
Watch the World Cup?
Yeah, that too, yeah. So I'm excited about that. Okay. It's Saturday. It's going to be a tough one. Yeah.
And who are they playing?
They are playing Russia.
That might be challenging.
No, we'll be fine.
Okay, I believe in you guys. I know this is a question that no fighter ever wants to answer, but it's one that I always have to ask is, what do you envision going down? How do you believe you get your hand raised on Saturday?
You'll find out when you get my hand raised.
Excellent, I'll see you afterwards. Best of luck to you, Stipe. Thank you.
So much.